Hello, welcome back.
Welcome back to another episode.
Yeah, I should usually always start this before we start. But
I
anyway.
To move my chair up, apparently. Yeah.
So, today's episode is on expectations.
What are we expecting?
Yeah, but before we start, definition of expectations, this is from the Oxford Dictionary. Expectations. A strong belief that something will happen or be the case. For example, reality had not lived up to expectations. Synonyms: assumptions, hopefulness, calculation, or projection. That's some of the synonyms of expectations. It's broad, but just like one of the reasons why this episode has come up is because you know what's happening here in Malawi. We just got a new cabinet and it seems like it has, you know, it's our expectations. Well,
it did not live up to our expectations.
Exactly.
And I think that's just one of the few things we were looking at in terms of expectations. But from what I was hearing from the whole thing that they're doing a battery of scrutiny and everything like that, like, you know, you'd expect them to pick angels, you'd expect them to pick some really big people. Mm-hmm. But even that in itself shows you, it sort of shows you who... a bit of a rewarding mentality, a bit of who's involved, but also that our Facebook opinions don't really matter. Because it's just you and me. We don't know if the president sees them or not. But still, the leaders tend to make a decision amongst themselves that will take us somewhere else.
Yeah, I actually read something where like someone was talking about how like when Nelson Mandela was first chosen, like the cabinet that he brought up, he picked Botha as Minister of Home Affairs.
The guy who was his former president.
Exactly. Gata Buthelezi in Parliament as well. And you know, everyone cried like, hey, hey, hey. But all he said was like, thank you, but if you chose me to lead, let me lead.
Yeah.
You know, simple as that.
And that's also just going back to the book I'm reading about Nelson Mandela leading like Madiba. Yeah, I haven't finished it.
Yeah.
But Buthelezi's story is actually that Buthelezi was Madiba's opponent in the election. So when Madiba won and he picked his cabinet, he picked the Buthelezi guy as his Minister of Defense.
Yeah.
I don't know if I've shared this story enough, but at some point, under strange circumstances, the President, Nelson Mandela, and his deputy, Thabo, were out of the country, which is very rare. And do you know who he picked as acting President? The Buthelezi guy.
Yeah.
So, you know, you pick the opposition guy, he's in your cabinet, he performs, you pick him as your acting president when you're out.
Yeah.
And he did a great job. But also, it just goes to show that our leader is not Mandela, he's a different case all in his own. And how he decides these things, we will see. But right now, we just can't set that. But even in the long term, I remember another story where Mandela had gone to the State House. And all the staff were asked, were very scared and tense, and asked him, so when will you dismiss us? And then he responds to them and he says, you know what, I'm not actually here to dismiss you, I'm sorry about this, but I want to work with you. Or were you waiting for me? Let me ask you in a more formal way, can I please work with you?
Yeah.
Speaking to the staff. So even in light of that, it's just that in Malawi, with a change of government, means some people go, some people stay. So essentially, even in light of our expectations and our current situation, I think the biggest lesson is, as a people, we should remember to set expectations that we can manage. We should set expectations for people who were able to communicate with, people who know our expectations, rather than creating assumptions of expectations.
Yeah.
And that's something even I do towards people related to me. That's something that we all do, assuming that just because I'm early, Chifundo will always be early. Unfortunately, he's not. But, you know, expectations are really what ruin the belief into a brighter future and even into better things.
Yeah.
So we have to really bring down our expectations and be like, I get what you're going for, but I'm not rushing into that.
Like, yeah, what you've said, like, I even remember last year when it's like part of our team, like society, like the executive, one of the things that I actually had to confess that I was learning as well is that I expect people to act as people, you know, sometimes we're like, the certain things you're like, yo, okay, this just makes sense.
Oh, yeah.
It's not even about like giving you something out of the, but like, I mean, like if you, let's say maybe people, I don't know, like let's say a door, closing the door, something simple, like you expect everyone to close the door when they come in, they get out.
Yeah.
But you know, people are not, you don't.
Not everybody. Yeah.
So that's something I really learned so hard last year. Like, oh my word, I need to lower my expectations. Even though it's like something that I should expect everyone to breathe.
Yeah.
Some people don't want to breathe, you know? And like, just talking about this, I finally also finished this book, Talking to Strangers.
Uh-huh.
I do want to finish it, man, because it's such an amazing book. But like, also the whole idea of it is like, we shouldn't really expect, so we shouldn't always go things with this presumptions of people, you know, like I might be in headsets, maybe you might think I don't want to talk to anybody.
I usually think you're rude.
You see?
But I'm also in headsets.
You see, so it's like one of those where like we always assume these things, and sometimes you know that there's a thing called mismatch. Just because I have this sort of smile on doesn't mean I'm actually acting or thinking I'm happy or not. Like some people just have a mismatch in what we expect them to react or be thinking.
Mm-hmm.
So just that idea, where like guys, we need to actually think beyond or not always expect what we see to be true or what we think it is.
So basically there's more to the story than what's being led on
in terms
of expectation. And this is just a general thing.
General,
we've moved away from our current situation.
Yeah.
But I feel like even with that, a lot of things have fallen apart because of expectations. And even the lack to communicate those expectations.
Oh my word.
You know, the things that we assume that it's obvious, but common sense isn't common. That's one thing. That's a very mean way of saying it.
It's hard to believe.
But also, we have different value systems.
Mm-hmm.
My value systems and Chifundo's are very different. Like, we come from totally different backgrounds.
Mm-hmm.
We are raised differently. Our families operate in a different manner.
Maybe not that different, but
it's a typical African family, it's a typical Malawi household. But still, the reality is people have a different set of value systems. So even when you've met somebody, I think it's best to tell them that, oh, my name is Chisomo, I was raised, I guess I believe in this, you know, I don't believe in this. You know, not everybody is for a certain movement you're pushing, not everybody's against a certain movement you're pushing. So it's up until you open up and you break down those invisible walls, you know, you become more vulnerable, that you get to really have people understand your expectations, but people also get to communicate to you what they expect from you.
Okay, so in that case, who, like, let's say examples of people who, like, maybe you expected something out of them, but oof, you got something else. Stories.
Why does he make us really tough?
We have to be personal, but yeah.
No. Okay, I just spoke about being vulnerable, and now I have to be vulnerable.
Exactly.
I feel like, so I have a very great imagination. When I hear something good, I love to picture something even better. So I think growing up, that sort of made me set very high expectations for my parents. And it wasn't up until I got older that I was like, this isn't working out, you know?
Yeah.
So I just had to accept as it was and leave them with the expectations that they can deliver.
Yeah.
You know, I think one of the things, because we sort of, we've known each other for our entire lives. So being in the same school, everybody in my school was always about soccer, or something really good. So I didn't know a soccer player. And I only supported Arsenal because I was the only team my dad supported and I knew. And the only player I knew was Terry Henry. So I'm glad that for that time period I could only know that one person. But even in light of that, as I got older, I was able to realize that I shouldn't expect everybody to like the same things. Nor should I force everybody to expect to like the same things. What I'm trying to say is, it's okay to be different, and it's okay to have a different background, rather than saying that we all come from Chiromoni,
We all
support bullets.
Yeah.
We don't all like the same things. Mm-hmm. We like different things for different reasons.
Yeah.
But we should remember that the most meaningful expectation we can set is to at least communicate and to understand the other person rather than attacking them for their likes and interests.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. But I had really high expectations in my childhood. I thought things work out in a certain way.
Mm-hmm.
But it only took me a while that, you know, a life tends to go like that. It's not just a straight line.
Yeah.
It's a very crooked road and things do fall apart.
Mm-hmm.
And when they do, it's how you respond and how you respond to those around you that matters the most.
I've lost my train of thought. It's a pause moment, bro.
So tell us about you and expectations.
Expectations, oh my word. I've always expected people who take leadership positions to really be like leaders, you know, where, as I say, where I've always said that like, I read a lot of leadership, and so that these things I'm like, if you're in this position, you should be doing this though. You know, that sort of thing. Because that's what I expect when people take on that, what is it, burden to like, I'm a leader. Mm-hmm. So I expect certain things like, you know, to take care of people, to really put those people first, and all, just all these just small things about leadership. I always expect, you know, leaders to like really oversee things as they should be. But now I also start to say like, sometimes people are just doing it to us all grow.
Yeah.
And they really don't know much as well, and they're growing in that. So I sort of like leveled it down where I don't expect so much from people who are leading me or in charge. Because if, for me, when I'm there, I take it all, man. Like, I'm in there, you know? So that's why sometimes I actually run away from responsibilities. Because I know, I know how tough it is, you know, and to see, but yeah, with that, that's when I started to forgive myself as well, like, yo, it's okay, I should expect so much from myself as well, you know, so I think that's something that I actually learned as well, or expectations rather.
So essentially, there's actually no expert when it comes to leadership.
Yeah.
I think there's a book that says, be such a leader that people will be willing to follow you even in the tough periods,
yeah,
you know,
yeah,
because yes, they should question,
mm-hmm.
they should hold you accountable,
yeah,
but they should still be able to follow you even when it's rough,
yeah,
you know. And I think we should appreciate those that are able to say, I actually don't know it all,
yeah,
I don't have it all together, mm-hmm. I really need to consult because I'm not a genius,
mm-hmm.
I mean, there's no person, well, only Jesus, but still, in light of the modern day. No person can actually know it all.
Mm-hmm.
Like currently, who is like World Health Organization is telling us that, oh, coronavirus is actually up on like, guys, you mean this whole time you told us it wasn't, and now you're like, oh, it's the same thing with the mask, the both masks. You know, it's those little things that at some point we need to admit as leaders that we're actually wrong, we didn't know it, and we need the help just as much as our followers need the help from us.
Yeah.
And yeah, leadership is more than just making the decisions that please everybody, but it's making the tough decisions that people won't like, that will have people talking.
Mm-hmm.
And it's even good when people from your own squad can criticize you and point out your failures, rather than them just clapping hands for you.
Yeah.
So it's difficult, you know, it's difficult to criticize the person you believe in, but we have to hold one another accountable.
Yeah.
And that's really something that the entire world over pushes for, regardless of who you are, somebody has to still hold you accountable.
Yep, that is, yeah, man. I don't know what else to say from that matter.
I think for the first time we haven't exhausted all the space in the memory card.
Yeah.
But this is the shortest, one of the shortest few. But even as we're wrapping up, I want to ask you, what are some expectations you have set for yourself or for those around you that have not been met? Why do you think you develop such expectations? And do you think you can tone it down, like, just bring it down? You know, high expectations usually lead to heartbreak and the like, and that's just a fact. So I know we expect a lot right now, especially in our current situation with COVID-19 and a lot of uncertainty, but the assurance is, the less we worry about it, the less we try to assume that we deserve something even better and accept what we have right now, the better our lives become. So yeah, I think my advice is usually take it one day at a time, let tomorrow worry about itself, and just keep on moving.
Yeah.
You know, never stop, just keep on moving. And speak your truth, speak your objective truth, regardless of what others may say. Yeah.
That's a wrap, man. That's touched me.
Ha ha.
But yeah, that is it for today. And we are at IBM.
ABI.
ABI. Oh my gosh.
African Business Institute.
Yeah.
I don't know why we want to go to International Business Machines. Hey, that's just a prophecy.
Yeah. But yeah, thank you very much, and we will definitely bring some other extra things coming up. And yeah.
Like and subscribe.
And, you know, actually listen and think about it, the expectations.
And have decent expectations.
Yeah.
Because we expect something from you too.
Peace. So yeah, we just recorded an episode on expectations, just someone died, and I didn't really say much because yeah, I was actually just taking in what you were saying, because if you even see, it's like it was really getting to me what you were saying, everything. And luckily I own the camera, so I'm like, wow, I need to say something about it. And you know, just the idea of expectations, I think it's fair in a way, but at the same time, it's like, wow, we all have certain expectations of each other, you know, society, families, friends, just so much. And where I am, I can feel it as well in so many different ways. And I feel like running away sometimes, you know, but what's keeping me going is just this whole idea that in your biggest struggles or problems, that's where your destiny is. You know, that's where you truly find yourself. So that's why I keep on, you know, taking every day like, now I can do this, you know, let's keep on moving. But other than that, I really do feel like running away sometimes. And by running away, I mean so many different ways of running away. It could be to, well, or just running to the mountains, a whole different country, being alone. And, you know, sometimes just, that's it. I'm not trying to be dramatic, but yeah, sometimes just like, why not just end it, you know, end this life? Because I'm really thinking like, what is it? Why should I be going through this? I just feel like I have set myself up so well, but that I shouldn't be here, I really shouldn't. And yeah, you know, just in the case of just the whole suicidal thoughts, good thing is that like with suicide, there's this whole idea of like coupling, you know, where certain things have to line up, the set perfect moment for someone to actually like commit suicide. Sometimes it's not just say everything is there, but like sometimes the right emotion has to be there, the right environment, and just everything sets up and that's it, someone can take their own life. So good thing. So I don't know, but yeah, I don't know, but as I said, just I think just taking every day by day. Like right now, what I'm actually reading, this is what I'm reading right now, you know, so I'm learning how to really think properly when I'm in such a downward place, just to really examine my thoughts and think positive, or get myself out of the place, or just be aware when a negative thought is coming. And yeah, I guess. And also at the same time, that's why I'm now working on this broad scale, like subconscious project called The Shadow, Trial Under the Sun, just talking about how, like, I don't know, you check it out. But yeah, so just this whole idea of expectations, they really hurt. And I don't know, I just hope people around me can forgive me. But yeah, that was what I had to say about just this whole idea. And that, yeah, this is really the end of the episode now. So yeah. You know, sometimes I'm thinking these videos are like my last words. I don't know, in a way, where like at least I said my part. So maybe sometimes somehow things will just line up as to what I was trying to speak on and all that. I don't think they are my last words, I don't think so. But they feel like it sometimes. But yeah, anyway, we finna be positive though. Like for real, but just I had to let it out, you know. So yeah.